So the 25 lapper is underway. The Zatopek 10 for 2011. First staging here at the Lakeside Stadium. An historic night in Victorian and indeed Australian athletics. And great to have a couple of the Kenyan visitors with us here. Jessica Trengove, the young lady who was successful in the City to Surf not long ago, the South Australian, has elected to take up the running. Just to identify the two Kenyans, the one most forward at the moment is Joyce Chepkirui. She has the longer hair. And back in about fifth place is Emily Chebet, the world cross country champion of 2010. She's run 30-38 on the road. She won the world cross country championships after taking some time off to have a baby. Quality athlete, Emily Chebet. And as Tom said, this is also the national championship of Australia, the Olympic selection trial, the Olympic qualifying standard 31.45. Last runner in the front pack is Melanie Daniels of Tasmania, and already the lead six have broken away. After the completion of the first lap, and hopefully we'll get some timing information for you. Jessica Trengove, who is the sister of one of the bright rising stars in Australian football, Jack Trengove of Melbourne. As we mentioned, Jess successful in the City to Surf going back a little earlier this year, just a few weeks ago in fact. Up in second place at the moment, Emily Brichacek, the ACT. Tucked into third placing, Belinda Martin of New South Wales. And she's already been passed by Joyce Chepkirui. On the board, as the athletes make their way to the top of the straight, the results from the women's triple jump. And now the Kenyans starting to make a bit of a move towards the front of the pack after letting the pace settle for the first couple of laps, and Joyce Chepkirui it is who takes up the front running. Brichacek second, Emily Chebet moving up into second placing, so the Kenyans are going to do as they so often do, control the race from the front, control the tempo of the race, maybe throw in a few slow laps. We have had just a few slight issues with the timing equipment, but we're back online now so you can see the times throughout the race. And it'll be intriguing, Tom, to see just exactly what the Kenyans do, because as we said, they do tend to throw in a quick lap and then they'll back it straight off and they don't allow any of the other runners to get into a rhythm at any stage.
Well, you're right, they've gone through the first 1,000 metres just on the 3:20 mark, so slowish pace comparatively to what the World Olympic Games qualifying standard is at 31.45, so 3:20 puts on about 33.20 pace. As we see the two Kenyans just working very nicely together at the front end of the field. Brichacek, the Australian cross country champion, into third place. Jess Trengove into second of the Australians, fourth place overall. Belinda Martin, she took out the 5,000 metre championship of Australia at Olympic Park earlier this year. But the two Kenyans, they're no strangers to racing one another. They tackled each other head to head on the road at the Tilburg 10K. On that occasion, it was Chepkirui that took the victory and posted in doing so the fastest 10K road time of the year, 30.38. So both very capable runners at the front end of the field of forcing a very fast race. We'll just see what they do, whether they start to just make an impact, wind up as we progress through, Peter.
Belinda Martin, who's up there in the leading half dozen, is third in the 2011 rankings. She's got a 35.29 to her credit in Sydney in March. These ladies looking to join some of the great names of Australian athletics in Carolyn Schiavolo, Lisa Martin as she was then, the late Karen McCann, Sonia O'Sullivan, Eloise Wellings the past couple of years amongst the winners of the Zatopek 10 for women. And already the Kenyans starting to just establish a bit of a break. 21 laps to go. And Joyce Chepkirui has the lead from her compatriot Emily Chebet. Emily Brichacek in third. Jessica Trengove, the young lady from South Australia, in fourth. Belinda Martin is in fifth place and now, unfortunately, finding herself in that awful position where you're in no person's land is Melanie Daniels, who's dropped away from the lead six, and she's racing herself down the back straight. Kenyon's winding up the pace. And now Chebet electing to move to the shoulder of her fellow countrywoman, Joyce Chepkirui. And it's Chebet who takes a turn in going to the front now. And their gap over the third place runner in Emily Brichacek now out to about 15, 20 metres at the top of the straight. And they will come down and get 20 laps to go.
So we'll get their 2,000 metre split with they collect 20 laps to go. Chepkirui going through 6:32. So they went through the first kilometre in 3 minutes 20, 6:32. The pace has quickened. And as we suggested before, they're just starting to work to their own tempo. No strangers to fast runnings. And some very high calibre athletes that they are. Indeed, when Chebet took out that 2010 World Cross Country title, she took on the likes of Lynette Masai, who was a 2009 10,000 metre track champion. And she took her on and successfully beat her over the distance in the cross country. So at the front end of the field, still Chebet and Chepkirui. Brichacek, the best place of the Australian, in third place. Back to Trengove and Belinda Martin.
And let's not forget the other four runners who dropped away very quickly, because it's going to be a long half hour or so for them. Andrea Alakovich of the ACT, Hannah Flannery of the ACT, Lauren Shelley. They're racing together, going down the back in eighth and ninth place. And Emma Craft of the Northern Territory is the lone runner at the back of the field, who's going to need your encouragement. Now, the Kenyans have just decided to back it off a little bit. And Brichacek has got up to within a metre or so after dropping back 15 metres back in the previous lap. Trengove still in fourth, and they're creeping ever closer as well. So that piece of elastic that was stretching a little bit before is now contracting, and the fourth and fifth runners back up to within round about 7 or 8 metres of the Kenyans as they head down the back straight.
So 2,400 metres, they went through 7 minutes 53. That puts them on a 32.50 schedule, so they have eased back. As we see, Brichacek just joining the two Kenyans and really tucking in behind them. And Martin and Trengove, as Peter mentioned, the elastic is just drawing them back in. And we'll soon see a leading group of five as Chebet and Chepkirui just ease back on the tempo. Brichacek, we're looking to move through with them. If they continue on this schedule, that will be personal best pace there for Brichacek from the ACT, the Australian. It's been to track championships as a junior in her earlier days, and looking to make an impact on the senior stage at this 10,000 metre championship of Australia. She's taken a national title in the cross country. A track title would add very nicely to the collection. As we just see that gap just starting to extend slightly again, the pressure being applied at the front end of the field. Chepkirui and Chebet, Brichacek, Trengove just losing a little bit of distance off the back of them, a couple of metres perhaps up the home stretch, as we see Martin just starting to flex off the back of Jess Trengo, finding it going a little bit tough. But it looks like the Kenyans have just accelerated slightly again, Peter.
Yeah, it could be a very important moment for Belinda Martin now, that Jess Trengo looks as though she's just got away from her, got that gap from fourth to fifth at round about 10 metres or so now. And Trengove and Brichacek well acquainted with each other, because we mentioned that Jess Trengove won the City to Surf. Emily Brichacek was actually second, beaten 36 seconds in the City to Surf earlier this year. So they're well acquainted with each other, as are the two Kenyans, and they've certainly wound it up here. They've really put in a fast lap, and perhaps got Emily into a bit of a false sense of security, letting her get up to within 2 metres or so, but they've really put the hammer down here, and all of a sudden, once again, the gap is out to 25 metres, and it's getting longer, and it's Chepkirui who is responsible for making the pace, and she's already getting about a 5 metre gap on Emily Chebet, and the gap now 25 metres and lengthening out to, in third place, Emily Brichacek. Jess Trengove is in fourth in the green outfit. Belinda Martin hanging on in fifth place with 17 laps to go, and then the length of the straight to Melanie Daniels of Tasmania, who is in sixth placing.
Very, very quick acceleration there from the Kenyans. They've dropped down now onto about a 32.15 schedule purely on that last 400 metres alone. So you can see they've really injected some pace and asked the question of the Australians here at Lakeside Stadium. And it's Chepkirui in front of Chebet. And just even between the two of them, the race really starting to evolve. Of course, the last time they did meet, we mentioned before, it was Chepkirui that had the better of her adversary in Chebet by the best part of 30 seconds. So we could be seeing a decisive move in this 2011 Zatopek race in the women's event. The two Kenyans have taken it upon themselves to inject some pace. And we could see only the third time that this race has gone under 32 minutes here this afternoon, this evening at Albert Park Stadium. So very impressive change of pace. It's just whether this continues or whether they drop back to the field and continue to play games.
Susie Power, Tom, actually has the race record, 31.26.34. That was set in 2001. The most prolific winner has been Natalie Harvey, who's won this race three times, now representing Great Britain. She won from 96 to 98. The Australian record for this distance held by the great Benita Willis, set in Paris in 2003 of 30.37.68. So the first of the lapping taking place now is about 12 metres between Chepkirui and Chebet as they come off the back straight. The gap has lengthened just a little bit, so Chepkirui throwing in her best work and trying to shake her compatriot in the middle stages. And they're coming up to lap another couple of runners. That will be Lauren Shelley and Hannah Flannery, who have been involved in a race of their own. Flannery in the black on the plinth, Shelley racing outside of her, and all of a sudden they're about to see the green of the Kenyans whiz by. 15 laps to go in the Zatopek 10 of 2011. Joyce Chepkirui rounds them up and leads by 10 metres from Emily Chebet.
So that 4 kilometre mark, 12.48, and they've brought it back down, 32 minute schedule, so they're bang on target, edging closer to that 31.45 Olympic Games A standard. The Kenyans injecting some pace, but we're quickly going to...
Congratulations, Brian, on the job. Well done, a lifetime in athletics. The gap has closed here between Chepkirui and Chebet. It's back to about 2 metres or so down the back straight. The lady in third has just gone past the judge with 14 laps to go. That is Emily Brichacek, and about 15 to 20 metres off her back is Jess Trengove, who is trying to keep Emily within her sights. Here's the lady coming down in fifth place now from New South Wales, Belinda Martin. They are the top five, and fifth is round about 300 metres or so, just a little bit less behind the Kenyans, who have put the hammer down in no uncertain terms.
Now we've seen Chebet just start to move back to her compatriot Chepkirui as they'll come down and collect. 13 laps remaining. In fact, Chebet maybe looking to start to assume some of the pacing responsibilities as they go through about 15:20. And that puts them under the 32-minute tempo, about 31:55 pace. So they're edging closer with every lap to that Olympic Games standard. And edging closer to making a little bit of history here at the Zatopek. No Kenyan has ever won this women's 10,000-metre event, and only on four times of internationals taken this trophy offshore. So the two Kenyans, well, they're doing a very good job at this stage. Chebet from Chepkirui. And they're two of the form 10,000-metre runners this year, particularly on the road. Kepkarui's time in Tilburg was the fastest road time of the year. So two outstanding athletes, and we're seeing plying their trade here at Lakeside Stadium as they go through halfway, Peter, 15:54.
Yeah, the halfway stage is down, and now it's only a matter of who's going to finish first and who's going to finish second between the Kenyans. As Tom said, Emily Chebet just taking a turn at the front after a bit of a surge a few laps ago from Joyce Chepkirui, and now they're going to run in tandem, and they're increasing their gap over Emily Brichacek, who's making her way just off the back straight now. Jess Trengove is round about 35 metres or so now behind Emily, so she did get to within probably 10 to 15 metres of the young lady from the ACT a few laps ago, but that gap has certainly increased now. So Brichacek looking comfortable in third, Trengove in fourth, Martin in fifth, and the Kenyans continue to race away. So it's all a matter of 1-2, and it's all a matter of the time in the Zatopek 10.
And we're talking about times. We look to the all-time list. Susie Power had mentioned 31:26, the race record set in very similar conditions to this back in 2001. Hayley McGregor, 31:43. Is the second fastest performance all time at the Zatopek 10. And we see these ladies, they're edging closer to that 31:45 schedule and edging closer to that second, third and fourth all time rankings in this Zatopek event. Of course, some of the other names in that top 10, the likes of Karen McCann, Carolyn Swallow, Susie Powers appeared there for a second time, Eloise Wellings, who have seen reign victorious the last two occasions at Olympic Park. Of course, Wellings has missed this evening's race, but she posted the qualifier over 10,000 metres earlier in the year, 31:41 over Palo Alto in California. Would have been great to see her out here racing with these two Kenyans really just starting to ramp up the pressure, work their pacing as they really start to put on a show here at Lakeside Stadium in this women's 10,000 metres.
And Tom, you just mentioned the late and great Karen McCann, and it took me back to the 2006 Commonwealth Games. And the stadium, the great stadium, the MCG, just a few kilometres away from here. And having had the pleasure of watching a lot of great sporting events around the world, I can tell you, I have never heard a roar like that when she came into the stadium that day. That was spine-tingling stuff.
It was one of those rare and extremely special moments in athletics, that one day back in 2006. Karen McCann, such a gutsy run to take out that marathon, and the crowd just responded to her. And It just leaves you speechless sometimes when you see moments like that in sport. It's really all about.
Yeah, to see athletes swapping the lead in the stadium at the end of a marathon, it was just quite an extraordinary race. As Tom said, a moment in time in Australian athletics history. Well, we're seeing the dominant nation in distance running for so long now, Kenya dominating here in the Zatopek 10. Emily Chebet is the lady in front. As we mentioned at the start of the race, took some time off before her World Cross Country Championship victory through there in 1904 with 10 laps remaining. And Emily actually took some time off to have a child. And what a successful comeback it has been. They've both run round about the same time of 30:38 on the road for 10K. And there's not going to be much between them. It's going to be a mouth-watering prospect. What sort of a finish are we going to have? Is it going to be a kick finish between the two? It certainly looks that way at the moment, unless one can make a break inside the next four or five laps, and you wouldn't think that's terribly likely, the way that they love to run in tandem, and that's exactly what they're doing at the moment.
It is indeed, as we see Jess Trengove just making her way through the start-finish area. She'll get 10 laps remaining through the 6 kilometre mark, just under the 20 minute mark.
Yeah, so
she's back onto about a 33 and a half minute schedule, but we see those two Kenyans working, so strolling together at the front end of the field. I just get the feeling that if Chebet's there with a couple of laps remaining, you look at her personal best over 1500 and 3000. 8:53 Chebet has run as recently as 2009 over 3000 metres. Now, it seems a little while ago, but that sort of speed in your legs at the end of this sort of endurance race, you just can't discount that, especially when she's running from the front.
Emma Craft, the lady just passing the start-finish line now, lap for the second time. Emma just hanging in there. Might be used to these conditions, Tom. A bit of rain on a warm day coming from the Northern Territory. That she'd be no stranger to that sort of thing. Often said the easiest job in the world would be the weatherman in Darwin, wouldn't it? Late storms, 32, every day.
Well, if it's the easiest job in Northern Territory, it's probably the world's hardest job as the weatherman in Melbourne. With the conditions we've had today, it's been beautiful morning, a little bit of drizzle late, but it just seems to be clearing as this night progresses here for the 51st running of the Zatopek 10. And we look through at these two leading Kenyans. And Chebet coming with some very good form off a cross-country preparation. And she took out the Tuxi Winona cross-country just in November last month in Eldoret. Very impressive run. Of course, she gutsed it out. She came from behind and out-kicked them in a sprint finish, so if that's something to go by, maybe that gives us an indication. The confidence that she's running with at the moment, not trying to put too much of a gap into Chepkirui, knowing that she's just got that ability to stretch away late.
The lady in third placing, Emily Brichacek, is just making her way up to the 200 start. So the lead for the Kenyans is round about 230 metres or thereabouts. And once again, we're seeing a change in the lead as Joyce Chepkirui rolls around the outside. And it's her turn to drive the bus as they go down the back straight.
And we'll quickly head down to the infield. We have another presentation to make, and this is for the Fred Lester Scholarship for 2011-2012. And in 2012, it will go to Mitchell Brown with the Fred Lester Scholarship being presented now. Fred Lester was a great fan of distance running and introduced this scholarship for emerging distance runners to help support them in their endeavours. We've seen Mitchell, of course, race 5,000 metres just a couple of weeks ago in the Victorian 5,000 metre championship. He's right up there with Liam Adams in his Sydney to Surf victory. He's also been very well performed on the Victorian cross-country circuit. We head back to race and still the two Kenyans, and with 7 laps to go, they're in a league of their own.
Clock ticking up towards 23 minutes in the Zatopek 10 for 2011. The first staging here at the Lakeside Stadium. A big welcome to you on this historic night in Victorian and Australian athletics. And don't forget, we have such a magnificent race to come later on, the final event on the program, the men's Zatopek 10, with, again, Kenya to the fore, but perhaps Craig Mottram or Ben St. Lawrence might be able to spoil the party a little bit later on. Chepkirui looking as though she's just stretching out a little down the back straight and just trying to get Chebet to keep in contact with her, but it seems as though they might have just lengthened the stride a little bit down the back there, Tom.
Just stretching slightly, and when we saw them go through with 7 laps remaining, 22:55 or thereabouts, so still tinkering around that 31:45, 31:50 schedule. And it does look, if they've made a slight acceleration at the front end of the field, they've continued to stretch that advantage. And we're really hoping that our Australians can continue their momentum. They're working back by themselves, but they are on track still for some personal best times within this group. But these two Kenyans, they're just doing it their own way, and they're going to take 6 laps remaining, 2,400 metres to go in this 10,000 metres, and they'll go through in 24:05, 24:05, and that puts them inside Olympic Games qualifying standard time. 24:05, they're on target for about a 31:43 schedule. So the pace has quickened, Peter.
Yeah, they certainly did warm it up, because just looking at Emily Brichacek, when the two Kenyan athletes came down past the start-finish line, as it is in the 10,000 metres, both start and finish, and the lead was about 300 metres after a little while ago. It was only around about 230. So they've certainly warmed it up, and this is going to be a wonderful finish between these two great athletes. Brichacek hanging on into third place at the moment. Let's just have a quick look at the gap between herself and Jess Trengove. It's round about 50 metres, maybe a little bit more than that, as Jess just comes to the top of the straight. And the Kenyans also coming to the top of the straight, so they're not far away from getting up into sight of the fourth place runner.
The result just quickly in from the men's shop, with Dale Stevenson, the Commonwealth Games bronze medalist, 19 metres, has taken out the competition in front of Tasmania's Todd Hodgetts, 15.21, 13.90 for Shane Carstairs in third place. As we see, 2,000 metres remain now, five laps to go. Chepkirui takes them through, 25.21. And they're on 31.40 schedule, ladies and gentlemen. Inside Olympic Games qualifying time, these two Kenyans. And inside the schedule to put them up to second and third on the all-time rankings for the women's Zatopek 10.
So 31.45 is that time that Tom is talking about, the Olympic qualifying standard. And in the race for the leading Australian, it is Emily Brichacek from the ACT at the moment, from Jess Trengove of South Australia.
So in the 32 years that we've seen this women's 10,000 metres occur as part of the Zatopek program, only on seven occasions have we seen a sub 32 minute run. So we are witnessing something that is quite rare in the context of this event. And this added calibre of these two Kenyans, they're going to take four laps remaining as we see our best place Australian, third place overall, moving through. That's Emily Brichacek. Jess Trengove now in the sights of Chebet and Chepkirui. So Trengove has four laps remaining. In fact, it's our leader with four laps. Trengove has an additional one. But the Kenyans, they just continue to stretch away, and their tempo, it increases. You've seen them drop. They started out on about a 33.20 pace. They dropped it to 32.10. They've just edged closer and closer through the race, winding up the pressure, applying it, asking the questions of the field. And it's only two that have been able to respond, and it's the two of them, Chepkirui and Chebet.
Yeah, and there's only one athlete now that the Kenyans haven't lapped, because they've got past Jessica Trengove down the back straight, who is still in fourth position. And they continue to wind up the tempo here. Just a little bit over three laps to go. Who's going to kick it down? Chebet goes up to the shoulder of Chepkirui now and takes over. Is it going to remain that way for the next three and a quarter laps?
Is this the start of a move that could be the outcome of this race? Chebet has moved around the outside, taken a couple of strides, but Chepkirui's marked it. Maybe they were just alternating the pace routine, but you have seen a slight advantage stretch out, a couple of strides, but in this sort of racing, as they come through to collect three laps remaining, a couple of strides can be the kick, the incentive that you need just to start to get that slight edge as they drop down towards the line. So 27.54 as they go through, three laps remaining, about 31.40 schedule, so they're right on time, well on schedule. We're on track for a very rare performance in this women's 10,000 metre event. Only Susie Power has gone through on a faster schedule when she set the race record back in 2011. As we see them just starting to move through the back markers again for the second time. I think that's Belinda Martin they've gone past, sitting third place overall at this stage. And it's Chebet. You can see them stretching out the long strides down the back straight. They're going to go through with 1,000 metres remaining very, very shortly. 28.31. So they're inside 31.40 schedule now. The Kenyans, they've just increased the tempo again, found another gear. Let's just see what it comes down to. It's almost two laps remaining now in this 2011 Zatopek 10.
So the last K in 3.10 or thereabouts for the Kenyans, and the lady they have in their sights is the leading Australian, Emily Brichacek. What about some encouragement for her, ladies and gentlemen, as they come down now with the Kenyans only around 25 metres or so behind her. With two laps to go, our leaders. Chebet leads, Chepkirui in second, a metre between them, and their gap, well, we can measure it now. It's about 380 metres over the lady that they are immediately chasing, Emily Brichacek, going down the back straight. She has 2 3/4 laps to go, the Kenyans with 1 3/4 laps to go, and Chepkirui makes a bit of a surge down the back straight now.
So it's Chepkirui that's taken over the pace. Chebet just a couple of steps back, and Chepkirui trying to extend that elastic that's been attached between the two of them for the best part of 28 laps. of Lakeside Stadium. Chepkirui, we remember, in Tilburg on the road, 10 kilometres. She stretched them out over the last 1,000 metres to run to the fastest road time of 2011, and she's just started to press the buttons of Chebet, accelerating slightly, making an increase in that margin. They're going to come down one lap remaining. It's going to come down that last minute acceleration. I see Chepkirui just starting to try to extend, but Kibet's hanging right in there, Peter.
Who's it going to be? Here's the most welcome sound in the 10K. The bell. Chepkirui is starting to crank it up. The gap is about 5 metres or so. Can Chebet respond? It doesn't look like it just at the moment. And Chepkirui has got the break going down the back straight. 300 metres to go. The string's about to break. It might have already broken. Chepkirui now starting to open up and sprint away. And she's about 15, 20 metres in front of Chebet now with 200 metres to go in the Zatopek 10. It's been a dominant performance by the two Kenyans. Chepkirui's lead still maintained at 20 metres. An impossible task now for the world cross-country champion in Chebet to catch her. And this has been a wonderful performance. Let's keep an eye on the time. Remember, 31:45 is the Olympic qualifying standard. And it is Joyce Chepkirui of Kenya drawing away to taste victory, the first ever victory at Lakeside Stadium in the Zatopek 10. Chepkirui is the victor in 2011. Chebet Brave in second place, beaten about 25 metres. And we keep an eye on the battle for third.
We'll have to wait officially on that time because 31:26.2, that is unofficially a new race record. We'll wait to see Susie Power, 31:26.3. Back in 2001. We're going to have to go to the photo finish judges on that one, but such an impressive final 400 metres from Joyce Chepkirui, stretched her compatriot and Emily Chebet right out as Emily Brichacek and Jess Trengove collect one lap remaining. And they've got the fight on for the medals in the Australian Championship race. Belinda Martin in third place. But it's Brichacek down the back straight, the best place to the Australians, looking for third place overall. And the national title, her first at this distance on the track, Peter.
It's been a wonderful performance by Emily Brichacek, and we've just heard that it is a new race record in the Zatopek. 31:26.10 has broken Susie Power's race record by 0.24 of a second. What about that over 10,000 metres? And let's pay due heed to Emily Brichacek making her way up into the straight now. Wonderful performance to be the first Australian home. She was teased by the Kenyans in the middle stages. But the lady from the Australian Capital Territory, Emily Brichacek, the first Australian across the line in the national championships. And Jess Trengove finishes in fourth place now, the young lady who won the City to Surf earlier this year from South Australia. Welcome the fourth place getter, Jessica Trengove.
That'll be a new personal best there for Trengove. Best entering this 33:38. So she's gone inside that. So great performance there to take the silver medal in the national title. Fourth place overall as we see Belinda Martin coming down to the line here. And she'll collect the bell with one lap remaining. We just have to take stock of what we've seen here. The first Kenyan to take out the women's 10,000 metres. A race record.